You'll probably meet someone you hate in college and forget all about me.
Nah, I don't think that's possible.
Wow, really is the end of an era.
Oh my God, I just realized that this is our last first day of sophomore year we'll ever have. I'm gonna cry.
Right, this reminds me of a problem I want to talk to you guys about. We're not cool.
Would a not cool person wear one dangly earring?
Was that a choice, or did you lose your earring on the bus?
I didn't ride the bus. I rollerbladed.
All right, my turn, my turn, my turn. Never have I ever had sex at school.
Anissa, how dare you? Cheers, babe.
Yeah, drama room.
Miss Thompson, they had sex in the drama room.
Yeah, I got that, Fab. Thank you. And once again, you can just call me Lindsay.
All right. Never have I ever hooked up in my bestie's bed. Ooh.
Fabiola, you better pick up that damn cup.
Devi, are you still praying? Our gods have other stuff to do, you know?
I was about to ask for good grades.
Now, grab your textbooks. We need to go.
Devi, that textbook has been blessed. If it touches the ground, I have to take it back to the priest. I don't have the time to go to Rancho Cucamonga today.
Devi, you better be up. Arriving 2 hours early at the airport does not include time for a random screening at security.
You're up? Wide awake, fully packed, mostly showered.
So, you're ready?
Yeah. I think I am. Wait, I forgot something. You start loading the car, I'll be right back.
Okay. Oh. Devi, I made you a lunch.
That's Davy's cousin, Kamala. She moved in after Mohan's passing to complete her PhD at Caltech. Devi is not a fan.
I don't bring lunch on Tuesdays. It's square pizza day.
Devi, don't be rude to your beautiful cousin.
I'm not that beautiful.
Sorry, are you a model?
Oh, thank you so much. No, I'm a biologist. I could never be a model. I'm too curvaceous.
Do you want to get out of here?
I can't. My mom will kill me if I leave. I'm so sorry.
Oh.
I'll cover for you. Go.
Mr. Chan, it smells like shit over here.
What? No, it doesn't.
Yeah, it does. It smells like there's like actual shit in this room.
There's not. The room was cleaned over the summer.
Okay, well, what about those vents? Did they clean those vents over the summer? There could be shit up there. You don't know.
Eric, enough? We're playing. Strings, lead us in.
Mr. Chan, I can't play like this. You come over here and sniff and tell me there's not shit nearby.
God damn it, Eric!
So, how'd I do?
Good enough to be a JV alternate!
Yes!
What am I talking about, bro?
Oh, all right.
Everybody, we have a new transfer student. Anissa, please, introduce yourself.
Hey, what's up? I'm Anissa.
I transferred from Chilica Prep.
Oh, shit, should I say more? Shit, sorry for saying shit. Okay, yeah. Am I nailing this? I don't know what to say. I play soccer.
For real? What position?
Defense.
Checks out, she's legit.
Never have I ever hooked up with... Ben?
Oh, been there.
Nirmala, mommy?
Nalini, so happy to see you. Come, come,
so
come.
So nice to see you.
Did you always have this many plants?
Oh, I might have gotten a couple since the last time you were here. Come, come,
thank
sit,
you.
Sit.
Yeah,
eat something.
Oh, okay.
You are too thin, Ma.
Okay.
The parappa's good, no? And to think you almost didn't get any. The shopkeeper said he was out of lentils. I said, go look in the back. 1 minute later, he returns. And in his hand, lentils.
Now go play your harp so your grandmother can show everyone the dip she practiced. And then go right back upstairs.
Okay. Nallu, you've been criticizing that girl all weekend. Need I remind you that I'm the bridezilla here?
I'm sorry, but she needs to grow up.
You know why you're picking fights with her, right? Because you're scared that she's leaving. I used to do the same thing with Mohan. He would be heading off to the airport and I'd yell at him because his clothes were too wrinkled or his hair was too long. Don't waste your last night with her, Nallu. I know it's hard to let go, but it's time.
Have you seen the nurse's new haircut? I love it.
No, I have to check it out.
Guys, sophomore year is gonna be our year. I can feel it.
Sophomore actually means wise fool in Greek, so it can really go either way.
Whoa, wait, who's Beth?
Remember that party where you two-timed Paxton and then he got hit by a car and then his swimming career was over?
Okay, yep. Everyone remembers that.
Me and Eve had a makeout sesh on your bed.
Oh, damn.
No, I'm actually not mad. That's hot.
We can meet at my house. I got a shitload of Uncrustables in the freezer.
Nice.
Wait, so who are you?
This is Devi. She's cool. And she's good at this stuff, so it's like a guaranteed A. So I asked her.
Sweet.
And I know you'd never be my boyfriend because you're you and I'm me. But I was wondering if you would ever consider having sex with me? Oh my God, I am such an idiot. I'm so sorry. I can't believe I just did that.
Yeah. Okay.
What?
What? That actually worked?
Just sex, right?
Just sex.
I'm down, but I can't tonight.
Wow, okay, twist. This is surprising. Looking forward to it. We'll circle back about it.
Well, I guess I should also drink.
Why?
Oh, I definitely had a couple solo sessions on your futon.
Come on,
what? I flipped the mattress over when I was done.
I sleep on that thing, bro.
You're asking me to tell you if I think you're bangable?
Yeah.
Davy, I can't do that. Ethically, legally, and most importantly, it's creepy.
So you agree with Ben Gross and the whole school and think I'm a disgusting troll?
Hey, I am not going to tell you I think you're sexy. I will tell you that kid sucks and you should ignore him.
Dr. Ryan, you know how much trouble I have taking the high road.
I do. Why don't you sit down? When I first met you, you were a closed-off, angry little thing. You didn't want to get in touch with your feelings, your pain, your trauma. All you wanted to do was break stuff. Hell, I had to start putting all my ceramics away before you came in.
Sorry.
But look at you. Look how far you've come. You faced your trauma, and you came out on the other side. And I'm sorry to get a little emotional, but there were some times there when I was really worried about you, Miss Girl. Look at you today. I am so proud of you. You survived, baby. You're a survivor.
You really mean that?
This little college thing, this is just a bump in the road compared to everything you've already overcome. You can do anything you put your mind to.
Thank you, Dr. Ryan. And thank you for helping me. I'm sorry about your face.
That's all right. That one was a little ugly anyways.
This disgusted reaction belongs to Ben Gross, Davy's nemesis. Because Davy and her friends were an ethnically diverse group of academically focused, I can't think of a better word for dorks, the rest of the school called them the gently racist nickname, the UN. It was widely known to have been created by Ben.
Do you know when you can't use your legs for no medical reason, it's called psychosomatic, which my dad says means fake.
Davy, I think we should be together.
Really?
Yeah. Like, when we both get to school, let's give this a real try.
New York and New Jersey aren't that far away. I mean, culturally, they're in different galaxies, but geographically, I think we can make it work.
Okay. As long as you stop shitting on Jersey.
God, it's just so easy to. But for you, I can try.
Then I'm in. Okay, I should go home. I have to head to the airport soon. Oh, shit. How am I gonna get back into my sari?
Oh, I'll pull up a YouTube video.
Hey, gods. It's Devi Vishwakumar, your favorite Hindu girl in the San Fernando Valley. What's poppin'? It's the first day of school, and I thought we should have a check-in. I think we can all agree that last year sucked for a number of reasons. So I thought of a few ways you guys can make it up to me. One, I'd like to be invited to a party with alcohol and hard drugs. I'm not gonna do them. I just like the opportunity to say, no cocaine for me, thanks. I'm good. Two, I'd love for my arm hair to thin out. I know it's an Indian thing, but my forearms look like the friggin' floor of a barber's shop. And lastly, most importantly, I'd really, really like a boyfriend. But not some nerd from one of my AP classes. Like a guy from a sports team. He can be dumb. I don't care. I just want him to be a stone-cold hottie who could rock me all night long. Thanks for considering. I know when we normally talk, I usually ask for stuff like smaller pores or a boyfriend who can do one-armed push-ups. But this morning, I really just want to say thank you. I feel really, really grateful. I have this awesome life full of dope people who care about me and who love me. So thanks for always looking out for your girl. And if you wouldn't mind keeping an eye on my mom while I'm gone, I would really appreciate it. Also, wouldn't be mad if you equally distributed my freshman 15 between my boobs and my ass. No. Never mind, forget that. Just please take care of my mom. She deserves to feel really lucky too. Anyway, I love you guys. And I'll see you at Princeton.
As she said, this is Devi Vishwakumar. She's a 15-year-old Indian-American girl from Sherman Oaks, California, and it's her first day of sophomore year. And I am legendary tennis player John McEnroe.
Point to Mr. McEnroe.
Wow, I look great there. Devi finally had both the boy and the college of her dreams. There would be other dreams, of course, like becoming the first Supreme Court justice who's also a hip-hop artist. But in this moment, our little hothead from the Valley was pretty happy. So, this is John McEnroe live from Princeton, New Jersey, signing off. For now.